So we recently got a comment on one of our videos asking us to cover the basics of filters. And we thought, hey, that's a great idea. So in this video, we'll be talking about the absolute fundamentals of audio filters. What are the different types of filters? What do all the names and the different numbers mean? And most importantly, what is filter resonance and how can it help you get that perfect swoosh sound? So filters are one of the most fundamental tools used in sound engineering and sound design. They help us get rid of parts of the audio spectrum that we don't want and highlight the nice frequencies that we actually like. A filter's main and most important characteristic is its cutoff frequency. This is the frequency around which the filter operates. And we can organize filters into four types, depending on what they do to the signal around this frequency. We have the low pass, the high pass, the band pass, and the bandstop filters. And here's a neat little animation that explains the differences between them. A low-pass filter, also referred to as high cut, allows all frequencies below the cutoff frequency to pass and attenuates the level of the frequencies above it. A high-pass filter, also referred to as low cut, does exactly the opposite. It allows all frequencies above the cutoff frequency to pass and attenuates the frequencies below it. A bandpass filter is like a low pass and a high pass filter combined together around the same cutoff frequency. It allows the frequencies around its cutoff frequency to pass and attenuates frequencies both above it and below it. A bandstop or band rejection filter is the opposite of a bandpass filter. It attenuates the frequencies around its cutoff frequency and lets all of the frequencies above it and below it pass. A very aggressive bandstop filter is also referred to as a notch filter. Of course, these are the most simple filters, so if you would like some more info on more specific filter types like formant filters and comb filters, or you want to learn more about how filters are used in synthesizers for sound design, for example, then leave us a comment down below. Okay, so the basics are out of the way, so let's dive a little bit deeper now. Not too deep, just a tiny bit. The frequencies that a filter allows to pass are called the pass band, and similarly, the frequencies that the filter blocks are called the stop band. Ideally, we would want all the frequencies in the stop band to be infinitely attenuated, or basically muted. In reality, that is impossible, so the attenuation happens gradually the deeper we get into the stop band. This rate of attenuation is called the slope of the filter, and it's usually expressed using the unit of decibels per octave. The larger that number, the steeper or more aggressive the filter is. So you'll often see filters categorized according to their slope, such as 6 decibels per octave, 12 decibels per octave, and 24 decibels per octave. Let's quickly hear that in action. Here's our sound example unfiltered. Now, let's apply a low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of 2000 Hz and a 6 decibels per octave slope. What this means is that now, one octave above the cutoff frequency, the sound is 6 decibels less loud. One octave above a certain frequency is just double that frequency. So in this case, with our cutoff frequency at 2000 Hz, this means at 4000 Hz, it will be 6 decibels quieter. Let's change the filter slope to 12 decibels per octave. Now at 4000 Hz, the sound is 12 decibels quieter. And the same thing at 24 decibels per octave. You can imagine that it's the same for the high pass, but the other way around. So let's use the same example, but this time with a high pass filter set at 500 Hz. Because we're now using a high pass, the slope of the filter tells us the amount of attenuation one octave below that frequency. So instead of doubling the cutoff frequency, we have to halve it, so now we get 250 Hz. Let's hear that in action. Another characteristic that you find very often in audio filters is the resonance or Q factor. Resonance actually increases the amplitude of the frequencies around the cutoff point and highlights them. The more you increase this resonance, the more you'll notice that it leads to a whistling kind of tone. Usually, filters with a steeper slope will have a stronger and more colorful character when their resonance is increased. So let's listen to an example that will help you understand resonance. As you heard in the example, filters don't have to remain static. They can become even more interesting sound shaping tools by modulating their cutoff frequency and the amount of resonance. Like in the example, that can be done during a musical phrase, or even per note, or maybe both at the same time. This is one of the most fundamental and fun ways of doing sound design on a synthesizer. Now that you've learned a little bit about filters, you're probably also going to want to learn another one of the most fundamental tools in sound engineering, which is a compressor. So go watch this video over here, which explains the basics of compression, or alternatively, go watch that video, which YouTube thinks you will like. Go ahead. They're really good, I promise.